morning to all of you. Now we are going to start with one of the sessions, how you are going to play the video on Android. So there is a video view control. That control we have to drag and drop. So this is the code to play the video. The first thing is that first we have to design the layout, that is XML. So here is the XML activity play video. Now when you go on this activity, you will find the video view. So this is the video view we have just drag and drop. So here is the name video view, and this control is present over here. So when you go on this controller, you will get the controller. In the gadgets, this is the video view. So in the gadget you will get video view. This control we have to just drag and drop the control. Now this control is used to play the video file. Now when you see the XML, there is only one thing, that is the code for the video view. So you can just drag and drop the video view, and later is the Java program. Now this is the code for the Java program. Now here we have to set the content view r.layout.activity_play_view. So we have initialized the activity. So always there is one Java file and there is one XML file. Here we have to map the Java file with the XML file. So set content view, it is a function we have to call so that mapping should be done. So for this play video file Java file, there is one XML file. That XML file is initialized by r.layout.activity_play_video. Now next thing, we have to define all the controls present in the XML. So the control we have drag and drop is video view. This is the object, this is the casting, and find view by ID, it is a method called. Now when you call this method, we have to initialize r.id.videoView1. So this is the control, this is the ID of the control. We have to initialize the control by the ID. Next we need a class media controller. Now this is the class we have defined, media controller. Now this class is present in android.gadget.mediaController, and video view, the class is available in the android.gadget.videoView. So for creating a media, we need a media controller class. So media controller, it is a class. Object is small m, media controller is equal to new media controller, and context this. That means for this current context or for the current class, we want to initialize this media controller class. Next, we have to call a method set anchor view. Now this is the view we want to set. So media controller dot set anchor view, this is a method called, and this, for this method we have to pass the object of this video view. So by this method the anchor view is added. Next we have to give the location where the particular media file is available. So uri is equal to uri.parse. So uri is a class. So this class is present in the android.net.uri package. So I'm importing that package, and uri is a class, is equal to uri.parse. Now parse is, it is a static method. This method is available with the uri class. Now here we want to initialize the exact location of the file. Now exact location will be environment.getExternalStorageDirectories.getPath plus is equal to media. Now media is a folder, and 1.mp4 it is the name of the file. Now when you run the program, you will get this folder also. Now this folder is present in the emulator. After that we have to set some parameters. So video view object dot set media controller is media controller. Video view dot set video uri is this uri, and video view dot request focus is, request focus is nothing but the cursor is going to blink on the calling object. So we have to request focus on this particular control, and if video view dot start. So as soon as the file is loaded, the file is going to start automatic. Now this is the by default code. This is not code needed for the playing the video file, but this is the by default available code. Now this was the file. This was the project or this was the program to run a file. Now where this file is stored? This file is stored in the emulator. So when you run a program, I'll show you how where this file is going to store. Now suppose I want to run this, I want to initialize this play video in the Android manifest as first file to be run. Now here we have to initialize this play video. Now if I initialize this, I want to run the file. Now when you run this program, you will get output like this. If the file is available, it is going to run the program, otherwise it is going to give the error. So can't play this video file. It means that either the file format is not supported or the file is not available. So most of the time the file is not available. Now how you are going to check where this file is available or what are the file systems of this emulator? So when you run the emulator, you can check the file systems. So in the view you can click on the tool windows, and in the tool windows you have to click on the device file explorer. Now in the device file explorer, here you are going to check all the file systems. So inside the data you can get the database. So when you talk about database, you are going to see how the data is going to be added over here. Next, that is MNT folder, product folder, SD card folder. Suppose I want a SD card. Okay, these are all file systems available with the mobile. The same are available over here. If you download anything, this will be present in the download folder. If there are images by the camera, you can display that by using this camera. So if you want, means by the emulator, if you capture any images, these are stored in the DCIM folder. Inside DCIM there is a camera folder. So in the Android folder there is also data folder. So this file structure is same as the mobile device. So if you keep any files over here, okay, or otherwise you can do one thing, you can store on the SD card also. In the SD card you can create a folder, and that folder location you have to give in the project or in the program. So over here you can give the location. So here the location is media is by default folder, and 1.mp4, that is the present file mp4, 1.mp4 that is present on the device, but this is not inside the media folder. So media actually it is not a folder. So if you close this, the file will be disappeared, means the file structure will be disappeared. So when you open it, when a device is opened, then and then only the file system is going to be displayed over here. So this was about how we are going to play the video files. So if you have any doubts, any questions, you can put on the comments. Thank you.